All right, so here we have an example. X is less than 6. That's what I want you to do for the rest of these with words. I want you to say what these statements are saying with words. So with words, what is this statement saying?
Y is greater than
negative 3. What does that mean?
It is above negative 3.
Above negative 3, greater than negative 3. Any other way of saying what it means? Could it be negative? It could be, oh, you gave an example.
Yeah.
I thought you said negative 2, like negative as well. But it could be the number negative 2, right?
Or negative 1.
So all of these are valid, right? How do we show what Y could be?
I don't know.
Can we show a visual of it?
Like an example? Let's just be like 6.
Like here.
A 12 pack of donuts costs less than 12
packs
of
donuts. What's this symbol mean?
Equal.
Yeah, the name of this is the equal sign, right? It means two things are equal to each other. It means, like, if I say this, X equals 6, there's not a whole lot of visual you need for this, right? X is 6. But if X is less than 6, well, X could be a lot of things. And just saying X is 5 is not enough. X is 4, that's not enough. How can I show it to you that X can be, well, we're on this one. How can I show you that Y is greater than negative 3?
You can have an equation.
What equation?
Y equals 5 minus 3.
There. Nope.
That's
not making sense.
5.
All right. Does this give you any clues?
An error.
What's that?
Oh, where it is on the number line.
It's a number line. So where's negative 3?
Well, we don't have any more things. So
it could be anywhere we want it to be, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to not put 0 right in the middle just to shake things up. There's a 0 there. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. That's where negative 3 is. Can X be, Y. Can Y be right here?
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah.
Yes.
It can be anywhere.
Can it be, say this is 10. Can it be 10?
Yeah.
It could be anywhere. It could be infinite.
Yes, there are infinite. Like, if I were to put an infinite number of points, what would I wind up having?
A solid line.
A solid line, like from here
all the
over,
way.
But actually also up to here, and actually here, and over there. But what if I get to negative 3? Is that going to work?
Nope.
No.
Why not?
Because negative 3 is equal.
There's no condition where it can be equal. It can only be greater than. So how is it that I show it can get really, really close to negative 3, like negative 2.999999, but not to negative 3. How do I show that on the number line? You remember?
You put it right there with the dot. And then you like draw that line on top.
Just put a dot right there? But then it makes it look like that Y could be negative 3. Can it be negative 3?
Put a number 2.999 over.
Not filled in.
Not filled in, right? That's how we show that. There's lots of ways we could show it. That's a pretty good way of showing it. It's an indication of negative 3, but also it's open, so there's some way to tell that you can't be equal to negative 3. Because if that happens, if I put negative 3 right here,
that would be untrue.
Untrue. What's the one word that means untrue?
False.
False. I guess untrue is
untrue or
false is a shorter word. Untrue, false. Yeah. It's a false statement. So that can't be. And that's why we put an open circle there to show that if we can get as close as we want to, negative 2 and as many, you know, point, whatever many nines we want, but not negative 3. What's your problem?
I'm stretching out my arm.
Stretch your arm in your own bubble. Get it out. Upstairs desk. So sorry. All right, so how do we say what this statement is saying? Clint?
It was greater than 4.
What?
Greater than? No?
Or equal to 4.
Yeah.
Or equal to?
It's greater.
So it can be greater than, but it can also be equal to. So that would look like on the number line. And let's put a 0 here, 1, 2, 3, 4 right there. Right. So it can be anything that's greater than, so it can be way out here, there, it can go that way for all eternity. Any of these guys work. Shading them all in.
Shading them all in.
What about here? Is this okay?
Yes.
Zero?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah?
No.
Zero works?
No.
No.
No. If I put zero here, does that work?
No.
No, zero's not greater than four.
I thought it was negative four.
It's a positive.
I
just realized that.
So zero, no. So all these don't work only up until four. Let me go ahead and shade in that point because
yeah.
four is okay as well.
Mm-hmm.
All right, what's this last guy saying?
R
is less than or equal to. Those are all the four possibilities.
Negative 1.
So our number line should show a -1. There it is. And we can be less than -1. So how about -5? Is that okay?
Yeah.
-12. Is that going to be all right?
Yeah.
Just
yeah.
not zero.
Just not zero? Any other number works?
Any negative number.
Any negative number.
Or any positive.
But not any of these, and not any of these positive numbers.
Yeah.
Right? Does -1 work?
Yeah.
Yes.
It does. Because it can be equal to. That's what that little line means. It means or equal to. So that would be all right. Okay. So let's talk about these symbols right here. What's the symbol called?
Equal.
Equal sign.
Equal, yeah. It's an equality sign. Shows equality. Do these show equality?
No.
No, they don't. Yes, they show inequality. So all of these, even these, are called inequality signs. Okay, we can just call them inequalities. Inequalities is what those are. Because they do not say that both sides are equal. Some of them, for one particular number, they could be equal, but mostly they are saying that these two things are specifically not equal to each other. The only way that two things can be unequal is if one is bigger than the other or one is smaller than the other. Okay? So the only way y could not be equal to -3 is if it's bigger, which in this case it is, or it could be smaller. Okay? Let's rewrite these in a little bit different language. We could say that m is, I'm going to have you pick either at most or at least 4.
That
what would you say? That doesn't.
Easy.
That shouldn't be a 15.
No.
Is.
Ooh.
Really bad.
That's
mushy.
Yes. M is, what do you think? Is it at most or is it at least 4?
At least.
At most.
It's at least because it's greater.
Why don't you put it right in the middle? All
right. So,
at least.
At the least, at the smallest, the very minimum, at the very tiniest, at the least, it can be 4.
At most,
or
it can be anything.
Okay.
At most, it can be anything, right?
Well, let's talk about this guy here. R is, what do you think?
At most,
-1. Right? At most, the very most, the very biggest, the very farthest to the right on the number line that this number could ever get is -1. At most, it's -1. Same thing as saying -1, like less than or equal to -1. We could say this a different way. This will be the last way, I promise. M is 4 or
more.
Equal.
4. M is 4 or more. R is -1 or less. These are like the common ways that we hear people talking about in everyday language inequalities. Okay. At least, at most, this many or more, this many or less. So, let's test it out. What if I said that W is at most 14? How would you write that as an inequality with an inequality symbol? Looking for somebody who's not answered yet today.
Me.
You've answered today.
Oh, no. I'll answer again.
Francis already answered today. Molly?
W, and then I don't know exactly what to call it, but the lease sign with the line under it.
Which way should it?
Pointing to the W.
Pointing at the W, right? Because it's on the smaller side.
And then a line.
And then a line. So less than or equal to. W is less than or equal to?
14.
That's how we would read it strictly mathematically. W is less than or equal to 14. Okay. If you have you heard the alligator thing with this?
Yeah.
Okay, so let me tell you a story that I believe makes a little more sense, because I don't think that the inventor of this symbol was thinking about alligators. I think he was thinking, or she was thinking, well, W equals 14. No, not W doesn't equal 14, right? They don't want W to be equal to 14. They want W to be less than 14, right? So in my imagination, they said, well, I'll take this equality sign and I'll change it a little bit. Right? I want to communicate somehow that the W is a smaller number than a 14. So I'll just take that and kind of tilt this like that. And I'll tilt this like this. And this side is less. Like the distance between the two lines is smaller here and greater here.
Smaller,
this is greater. That's a made-up story. I don't know if that's where it came from, but it's a pretty easy to believe story because they had equality and then we invented inequality and made the symbol work that way.
Wait, would W be greater than 4 right there?
No.
You got W.
Yeah.
Open your eyes.
I am thinking.
And what number is this?
14.
14, okay. Not 4. You said 4?
I did say 4. This is.
Yeah,
you
did.
Yes,
wow.
You did. Okay, why don't you do an official replay?
We will later. I have a recording.
Okay.
You
said 4.
Okay, so is this saying that W is smaller than 14 or bigger than 14?
Smaller?
Yeah, it's small. It's saying it's smaller. Okay, because I imagine this as a, like I said, an equality sign that got. Both of these got tilted, right? We're gonna bring these closer together so the distance is smaller between them. Then on the other side, maybe we'll just scooch it. Okay. The distance between these two parts of what used to be an equal sign is less. The distance is smaller, and the distance here is bigger.
Oh, so W is smaller now.
W is smaller. It's on the smaller side of this symbol. The small side of the symbol is here, so the small number is over here. The large part of the symbol is over here. So the large number is over here.
Okay, yeah, I get it now.
Wait a minute. How would this compare?
W is more than 14.
So how do these two compare, these two guys here?
They're
the same thing. They're saying the same thing about W, that it is smaller than 14. It's less than 14. The last thing that I want to ask you about, ask you if you understand this. Let's say we take this inequality, x plus 2 is less than 8. Is 6, like if x were 6, would that be a solution?
No.
Yeah, it would.
First of all, how are we going to figure out if it's a solution?
I don't know.
Just plug it in for x, right? Test it out. And then once we've done that, how do we determine if it is a solution?
Then you can determine
it. It's true.
Well,
let's see if it's true. 6 plus 2, is it less than 8? What's 6 plus 2?
8.
Which just means it is equal
to. So it's equal to,
So is this true or false?
It's false.
It's false. 8 is not less than 8. So now, if I changed a little something, could I make this a true statement?
Yes.
Yeah.
With what?
Equal.
7.
I could put a little equals 2 like that. Right?
Mm-hmm.
That would work. Or if the numbers were different, of course, that would work. So now it is. Now this is a solution to that inequality. Let's try one more. And W minus 5 is greater than 12. So if I put in 22, W or 22, would this be a solution?
Yes.
How do we test it out?
We plug
it
in.
Plug it in for W, 22 minus 5. Let's see if it's true. What's 22 minus 5?
12.
17. 17 is 17 greater than 12.
Yeah.
Yes,
yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, yes, yes.
So if it comes out true, then yes, it is a solution. Comes out false, no, it's not a solution. We're not solving inequalities, we're just testing solutions to see if they are solutions, doing some graphing, doing some writing of statements, writing of you know, using symbols. X plus 2, the number x plus 2 is less than or equal to 8. If that were said as a sentence or written down in words, you could translate it to x plus 2 is less than or equal to 8. So, as I suspected, you guys are not, this is not new, not incredibly brand new, surprising stuff to you. So, okay. Well, I'm not surprised. I figured that was the case. Your homework is here. I bet you can get it done.
That's a crappy homework right there.
No, it's really weird.